Hi, welcome to How to Repair. I went shopping on the weekend to buy a new LG washing machine for you to do a video series on replacing all the components and also diagnostic videos, because there's a lot of old videos out there and we need to keep the website up to date. Now I've gone out and bought an LG FCV309WNE. I bought this because one, it had over 3,000 reviews on the website, but I went to the superstore to actually gain the experience as you, the public, would when you go into these places. And I spoke to quite a variation of different customers that were in there shopping for LG washing machines and other makes of machines as well. What customers are interested in today is not only the price, they're interested in the load capacity, they are interested in some of the other features, but the one thing that I did notice with all the customers that I spoke to is they were all confused on which ones to buy because there's so many choices under one brand. Now in this superstore, Currys, there were 15 or 16 machines on display, and there was over 35 machines on their website, all LG. And the variations between the machine from an engineer's point of view was not that different. Some of the top end machines have got the new suspension system compared to the old shock absorber system. They have got things like Wi-Fi technology, and some machines have even got AI technology built into them nowadays. But the difference between an 11-year-old machine, a 5-6-year-old machine and a new machine, I think you'll be interested in. We're going to do a strip down video to have a look at how it's made, have a look at all the components, and I'll be making additional videos on how to replace all the parts during the series. But what we're interested in is to have a look at this machine, and if you're looking for a review on the machine with regards how well it washes and everything else, you're on the wrong channel. This is about how the machine is built and how well it's constructed and how easy it is to maintain the machine, meaning access to the machine and diagnostic system. I hope you enjoy the video. Four transit bolts on the back of the machine. Then you've got the caps to put back on after you've taken them out. Always worth keeping these safe. I know you'll end up throwing them away, but if you ever move, it's always worth keeping these. Couple of tips with regards to installation. Firstly, when installing this, now in the UK, a lot of people have fitted kitchens and they install this into the units next to the sink and they attach this to the sink fitting. It is very important that the machine does not have a pipe coming from the sink unit going downwards all the way to the machine. It needs to have a U-bend in it slightly to stop siphoning from the sink back into the machine, because that can cause smells. Secondly, make sure you're putting it onto the correct fitting to make sure the machine is able to empty the water in the allocated period of time. And another thing a lot of people do is they push this down a stanchion pipe way too far. And what will happen is when it's on a rinse cycle, it could end up with a siphoning effect taking place and the machine continues to fill, but it's actually siphoning water out of the machine, which you'll end up using a lot more water than you should be, and the machine may get an error from this. Electrical system, it should always be connected to a 13 amp supply. Doesn't matter if you're in the UK or anywhere in the world, you really want to make sure that this is on a designated 13 amp supply and there's no other appliances on that supply if it is not a ring main, if it's a spur, because in Europe a lot of people overload the sockets and therefore this can then cause a voltage drop which would cause a problem with the circuit board. Okay, let's take the lid off before we put it onto the workbench. Lid, tap it backwards, it will come away. Okay, LG. Big thumbs up here. You've gone and put a drum into the machine that you can change the bearings on. This drum is splittable, meaning customers can choose to change the bearings at a later stage in life if they wish to. Too many manufacturers are building sealed drums with built-in obsolescence in. The second thing I love, you'll notice that all the components here have part numbers on it. This means that you can go to our website and just enter a part number and you will find the correct component for your machine, rather than making it overly complicated like a lot of manufacturers have done. Okay, I've quickly entered diagnostic mode for you, which will be the next video, and I will show you how to enter diagnostic mode on these machines and every stage of the diagnostic mode. But I've put it into diagnostic mode so I can control, so you can actually hear the sound of the machine. So I'm going into test one, which is a standard on this one. It's clockwise rotation, 45 RPM, but I wanted you to hear the spin on this machine. And the reason I wanted you to hear the spin, because I think it's a very quiet machine. For the money that you pay, I think it's well constructed. Of course, the test of time will say how well it's built with regards to the longevity of components, but this is on 600 RPM, and as you can hear, it's very quiet. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is take the back panel off. No difference in the construction design here. It's exactly the same as machines that are nearly 20 years old. Hold it in the middle. and just pull it away. Okay, standard LG motor system, maybe some variations on part numbers. I've done a video previously on the motor and the hall sensor, so if you want to go and see that, jump into the playlist. Looking down the machine, the standard shock system, there are three shocks on this machine. No access from the bottom of the machine, and there's no anti-flood device built into it either. So it means if you get a leak, the water will all go to one place. But I'll do another video on that, showing you how to find leaks on these LG machines. Okay, when it comes to the facial panel, this has completely changed in the way that it comes apart. It used to be a couple of screws and some clips, but now they've put some extra screws in on the top. So take the soap drawer out, press the button down, remove it. Two screws inside here, holding the soap box together. Here are the two screws we need to remove, but first we need to remove the wiring through to the display panel. And you need to remove this, take it off the clip, because when the panel comes away, it needs to have the space. You will notice here and here there are a couple of clips that you need to lift up, and the panel will then slide out. You will need to drop the soap box back a little bit. Then the panel will come away and you're able to thread this through to remove the panel. Again, part numbers written on everything. Big thumbs up. Okay, the construction of the front panel is slightly different. Not much though. Used to have a couple of screws underneath and you don't have those anymore. First thing we need to do is actually take the retaining band off the door seal. Using a flat blade screwdriver, we can remove that. Small items like that don't have part numbers on. Here is the model number of the machine. So I'm just peeling the seal back. Now I need to remove the two screws for the door lock. Now I need to remove the pump flap. Just pressing down these slightly will remove that. You've got the drain down hose, which is good. And then you've got one screw inside. Then you need to put the screwdriver down the side and you should be able to remove this completely. There are two screws in here to hold this panel in place. Now we can remove the three screws at the top. The panel will come towards you and you can just lift it up to remove it. In general, this took me roughly 5 minutes to take apart. It's really nicely made. I have to take my hat off. Someone at LG has really thought about the way the cabinet should be constructed. It is a little bit flimsy when it comes to the facial panel, but that's just me being petty, I think. It's not something you'd expect to be taken off on a regular basis. The door lock, straightforward, easy accessible. Pump, although this is a non-circulation version, so it's only got one single motor. The motor looks different. I suspect they've changed that over, maybe to a DC motor now, so it runs quieter. The heating unit is straightforward, NTC sensor and your element. Again, the cabling is nice and tidy. The suspension legs look pretty much similar to the old type, well constructed. There is facility in the bottom of this machine to have an anti-flood device, but it's not fitted on this model. And I imagine if you do have a leak on these machines, the water would build up in the base of the machine, which I'm not too keen on. I prefer customers to be knowing that their machine is leaking before they have a flood with a lot of water in the bottom. But, you know, that's just me being petty. The door seal I quite like. It's got a drain off valve at the bottom, or hose at the bottom. This means that any water that's left inside the drum, inside the seal, will drain off back into the drum so it can be emptied. The soapbox hose, they've got a new type fitting on the top here. I haven't had a lot of experience with this, but it's quite narrow here at the top. It might cause blockage problems if people use too much powder in the machine over a period of time, and it may be something that needs cleaning. The motor, as you saw at the back, is the same motor that they've been using now for at least 10-15 years, the direct drive system. Brilliant motor. The hall sensors were the only thing that ever caused them a problem, and you can see all about that in the playlist at the end, because I've already done the video on that. But in general, this is quite a well-made machine, and I do like the fact that every part is identifiable either by a scan code or it has the part number written on it, and this one has the part number written on it on the front there. In general, I think it's a good machine. I think it's good value for money. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please remember, keep the playlist saved to your favourites, as you'll have all the repair videos on this machine, changing all the components, diagnostic mode and everything else. And remember to bear us in mind if you ever need any parts. Thanks very much indeed for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And remember, there's a whole series coming up on all these LG washing machines. Thanks again for watching.